Okay, so we're going to start off by going either to the link that you see at the top, so wa.portal.arast.org, you should be able to get a link either from your instructor or your counselor or somewhere to get to this website. So that's where we're going to start. We're going to start at wa.portal.arast.org. Once you're here, on the right side, you're going to click on Practice and Training Tests. And immediately here, we're going to take the Practice and Training Tests. A new tab will open. That's okay. Now, since we're going just on the practice tests, we're not going to sign in with anything fancy. We're guest. Everything's fine. We're hitting Sign In. And for grade level, you can just select whatever grade you're in. I'm going to select grade 11. Go juniors. If you're in another grade, you can select that. It really doesn't matter. And then once you're through all that, you're going to click yes. That's our information. And once you're on this screen, we're going to scroll all the way to the bottom through all the other colors. And what we're really going to look at is the three different science tests just to see what sort of questions we're dealing with. So we're not going to be concerned with picking the right answers. We're just going to be concerned with seeing how the test looks. So I'm going to start with the grade 5 science. The settings are all good. Ignore. Don't worry about all the settings. We're going to select. And again, the settings are fine for taking the practice. And we're going to hit yes. And again, we're going to scroll all the way down to the bottom and begin test now. So this will take us into the fifth grade science test. Now again, we're not going to be concerned with the content. We're concerned with what's present. So you may notice in the upper right hand corner up here, we have the calculator function, zoom out and zoom in. Those are kind of our major tools we're seeing at the early levels. So if I click on calculator, you can see a calculator will pop up. Depending on how big your screen is, you can scroll up or down to see what's there. You can drag left or right and make it bigger or smaller as your needs are. And it's a pretty simple calculator. So there I hit 8. Let's say I want to do 8 times 3. And you can see there on the right, the answer shows up. So pretty straightforward calculator. You can clear all, start over. Let's say I want to do 8 times 2 instead. Gives me the answer. Oh, maybe I don't want to do 2. I want to do 4. So I can just hit the backspace and 4. And again, it gives you the answer automatically. Up at the top of the page, you're going to see this on every single one. Next moves you on to the next question. And ideally, you want to have everything answered on each page. Save and pause. Really kind of the same thing. Save saves what you've done. Pause, well, pauses it. Don't worry about pause unless your instructor tells you to. Here, little three bars are kind of your settings. You can walk through a tutorial, very similar to what we're doing now. Mark for review. What this does is if you select a page and mark it for review, at the end of the test, it'll show up in a different color, just kind of a reminding of yourself, oh, I wanted to come back to this problem. Notepad is exactly what it says. It's you can type there. Hey, look, I am typing. And I'm going to save that because that's very crucial to my success on this test. Likewise, you can strike through. So if there's information you want to kind of look at, you can select. Oh, carbon dioxide, and can't strike through that. Anyway, so we look through, they give us some information. There's a graph, I look at the graph, I look at the questions, which would be the greatest decrease in energy. Again, I'm not really caring right now what the right answer is, so I'm gonna select A. These sort of questions where you have the empty bubbles, only one answer can be selected. And once I'm confident with my answer, I can just hit next and moves me to the next page. This sort of page, you'll see there's information here on the left. You can read through it. You scroll. Hey, look, all this information. Likewise, you can highlight things. So let's say, hoop, there's a ditch next to the school, and I want to highlight that. Now it's highlighted. Now let's say that there's some words that are non-science vocabulary. So let's say you don't know what the word ditch is. You may notice there's these little tiny dots above the word. You click on it and hey, look, it tells you the definition. If you want more room to read, there's these buttons here at the top. If I press the right button, hey, now the whole thing is the reading situation. I press the left button. Hey, look, back to normal. Hit the left button again. Now it's just the questions. So you can kind of customize the screen to see what you want. So this one, there's a question there. Ooh, look, multiple questions on the same page. This happens. So notice if I try just to answer number two here and I go next, it tells you you must answer all the questions before moving on. So it even warns you that you didn't complete it. So I go through and these boxes here, I need one in each. So you can see within this bottom row, as I click through, I can only have one selected, but those are my answers. We go next because I answered it. Same thing as before. Notice this says select three statements. So if I only select one and I hit next, it again tells me you have to answer everything. So I say okay. And hey, look, those three look like good answers. And I move to the next. Again, text on the left, answers on the right. I choose one solution, and then you have to describe. Description goes here. And again, if you were actually taking this, you'd actually type out your answer, and yes, human beings will be reading that. So that is moving along. So questions, I've answered everything when you finish checking your answers. So because that's it, I can say end test. Because I've done 5 out of 5, you can actually see this up here as well. So I end test, I've reached the end. I click yes because I want to end it. No, let's keep working on it. I'm done, so I hit yes. You can review anything. So let's say I'm like, oh, I don't know about question two. I can click on question two again, and it'll bring me back to question two. Hey, look, it's question two. Oh, I really think it was B. I was wrong. It's B. Now I'm going to end the test. Now I'm going to click yes. Question two is now fixed, and I submit. I'm submitting. I'm sure I'm submitting. And that's it. That's some of the basic stuff that you're going to see. Now we're going to log out. Takes us back to the main screen. Please sign in. I'm signing in because we want to look at the other grade levels. Grade level 11 again. And again, yes. Doopy doopy doo. Scroll all the way to the bottom, and I'm going to take the Science 8 test. The reason I'm going through each of these, by the way, is that there's different tools they provide. If you're in fifth grade, you only have some of the fifth grade tools. If you're in eighth grade, you're going to see the fifth grade stuff and the eighth grade stuff. And then 11th grade, you have even more tools on top of that. So again, just going to scroll all the way to the bottom. Everything's good. I select what's there. Scroll all the way to the bottom. Yes, everything looks good. Scroll all the way to the bottom. Begin my test now. And it thinks. It loads me in. Generally, the same information that we saw before. We can see the calculator's still part of it. Zoom, by the way. I didn't zoom, so look, I'm zooming in. I'm zooming in. I'm zooming in crazily. I'm zooming out. So you can make it as big or small as you need. Calculator is still there, but now there's a periodic table. So that tells you we're going to be looking at some chemistry. The periodic table by default only takes up a small portion of the screen, but you can drag here on the side and enlarge it. Hey, look, it's bigger. So you can look around and you can see what information it gives you. So it tells us question has two parts. First answer part A, part B. So it shows us some pictures. I look at the pictures. So we have a new question type here. So it shows properties of Titan and then some options here. And we want to go from small scale to largest. And again, I'm not concerned with the right answer at this point. So here it literally is I click and I drag to where I want it. I click and I drag. What are we doing? We're clicking and dragging. Click and drag, click and drag. And so everything is in the order that I want it. Part B, so select a box identify that is most appropriate for viewing. So again, for each of these, I select one box. You can only have one box selected per row. So you can see with this bottom one, if I can't quite tell if I want to probe on the Titan surface or spacecraft orbiting Saturn, you can only pick one. And again, when you're done, you hit next. Now this one, again, kind of a click and drag sort of situation. It gives us some information. And there's some options here. So click, I want to use the black bar. So hey, black bar, white bar, little black bar, little white bar. And then we have to do it again. Black bar, white bar. I'm going to do two white bars in a row. I'm going crazy. Another white bar. There we go. And a black bar. And maybe after I'm done with this, I'm like, oh, I don't want that last little black bar. We can always delete. I don't like that black bar. Black bar goes away. I wanted a white bar instead. Oh, don't like that either. Gonna hit delete. Gonna delete that white bar too. There it goes. I want a big black bar. And again, now everything on this page is complete. So I hit next. Now notice, this is an important addition when you get to the eighth grade test. This is a locked question. So notice it's what it says, are you sure you're done responding to this item? Once you leave this page, you will not be able to change the response. Once you click yes, you are committing to that answer and cannot change it. The reason for it is that you're going to see the correct answer to this question on the next page. So once you hit yes, you are locked in. You cannot go back. And so we can see here on the left, here's what the answers should have been. Oh, I was very, very wrong. And we answer questions again, answering questions. Hey, look, more questions. Now, part of you might think, oh man, I might have missed that. But again, if I try to go next, it tells me I have to answer everything. If you get that message, that tells you, oh, I missed something. I'd better scroll down more. There we go. So I hit next. Now again, multiple parts, I see some labeling here, so click and drag, click and drag, click and drag. And that's the only thing there, I don't see anything else as I scroll. So I hit next again, are you sure you're done responding? Again, once I leave this page, I cannot go back because the next page is going to tell me the right answer. And we can see here, here is the right answer. And so here we have some drop down boxes. So you click on the little arrow, drop down box opens, in this case drops up, I select my answer, I hit next, are you sure you're done? Once you leave, you'll not be able to change it. So again, we're submitting it, we're locked in, and we choose, and then we describe. So again, anytime there's a big text box like this, they want us to describe. I'm describing things. And again, we hit next. I hit next, I've answered everything. If I'm done checking everything, and again, even though you can check things with this, once I hit end test, and I hit yes to continue, I can't change anything that was locked. I submit, and I'm done with that. So we have one more left to go. We're gonna go log out once again. Takes us back to the main page, you've seen it before. Like last time, we're signing in. I'm selecting our grade. Again, I'm going with grade 11. I select. And just like every time before, we scroll all the way to the bottom, start grade 11. Scroll all the way to the bottom. Select. Scroll all the way to the bottom. Yes. Scroll all the way to the bottom. And begin test now. So now we're on the grade 11 test. So gives me some information and asks for mass now. So maybe this is where the calculator would come in. Maybe this is where the periodic table comes in. Maybe both. There's the periodic table. There's the calculator. I can bounce back and forth between these tools as needed. Notice the calculator at the high school level is a little bit more complicated than it was at the elementary level. That makes sense. So we have a mass, just making up a number. 42 is a much better number to make up. And then we need to submit the response. Drop down menus. I think it's all done. I hit next. It lets me move on. Information on the left. I can hide the information. I can see more of it. It's exactly as we saw before. Again, I select an answer. Ooh, I like B. B is a good letter. And again, are you sure you're done responding? So this again tells me that once I leave this page, once I hit yes, I'm locked in. I cannot change my answer after this point, but I'm confident. I move on. It tells me the answer over here. Oh, wish I had that correct. Hey. And then I am attracting. I'm positive. I'm negative. So again, filling in the drop-down boxes. We hope we're getting this correct. And I keep scrolling down. Oops, this one now has multiple choice. Ooh, A is a good letter. D looks like a good letter. Notice again with the multiple choice, I can only select one at a time. Question 5, there's a lot of questions on this page. Be easy to miss one. Luckily, it's impossible to miss a question because it won't let you move on. C, no one likes C's. C's are average. B is a much better letter. Ooh, and an equation. Ooh, that equation looks dandy. And it tells me it's ready. The test has been completed, ready to be submitted. I can hit end test. I end the test. I click yes. I'm good. I can, again, from this page, review anything I want. Let's say I want to go back and look at question 2. I can go back and look, but remember, we were locked in, so I cannot change my answer anymore on that. So, darn, wish I would have paid more attention to that the first time instead of being filled with regret at the end. But I have everything. I submit. I'm done, and we're done. So that's it. That's the sort of questions you're going to see. That's the practice you're going to get, and all is